Hello, everyone. In this video, we'll look at images in the patent databases on Dialog. Like this one, which is for a device to keep your dog's ears out of the food bowl. We'll talk about why and how images are used in patents, what they look like, where they're found in the databases, and how they can be viewed and downloaded. I especially want to demonstrate for you how patent images can be a great tool to help you browse through your result lists on Dialog. So let's get started. On a basic level, the images in a patent record are illustrations. They show you what the invention looks like, and this can be very helpful. When we see the title, Improvement in Fire Escapes, we might think this patent is a new achievement in architecture. But when we see the image, that's really all we need. The idea is for people to jump out of a burning building with a parachute strapped to their heads. Notice the padded shoes to help absorb impact on the pavement. A patent image might show something as simple as a leash for walking your snake outdoors, or something far more complex with many numbered parts. We might call this one, How Many Inventors Does It Take to Change a Light Bulb? But in searching the patent databases, you'll find that a large number of the images are not these kinds of representational artwork. For example, many patents have chemical structure drawings. And for someone who works with this kind of science, this image really tells them what the invention is. This one shows a new form of remdesivir, the antiviral medication. There are diagrams or flowcharts that summarize complex systems or methods. Gene sequences are often inserted as images, possibly because if the text is scanned with OCR, optical character recognition technology, the C's and G's easily get mixed up, whereas an image of the sequence will capture the information correctly and preserve it. Formulas can be difficult to state as regular text and will often appear as images. And many patents use a variety of charts, graphs, and tables to explain or amplify what's in the patent. And there are design patents, which consist almost entirely of the image. So patent images cover a wide range of form and purpose. Now let's take a look at where these images are found in Dialog and how the different databases present them. There are some databases that do not contain images. The main ones would be INPADOC and IFI Claims. Then there are databases that contain one drawing per record, assuming the original patent has any images. The main one in this group, perhaps, is Derwent World Patents Index and also JAPIO. These databases contain what's called the cover drawing for the patent, but you have to click to see it. There are no thumbnail images visible from the results list. There's the Global Patents Bibliographic Database, which covers about 70 countries. These records contain all of the patent images for the patents, not just the cover drawing. However, as with Derwent or JAPIO, the images are not seen as thumbnails from the results list. The databases that help you make best use of patent images are the set of 31 full-text patent databases on Dialog. These cover more than 30 countries and patenting authorities. They contain the full text in both English and the original languages, and in addition, they contain all of the patent images from the original document. And importantly, you can see anywhere from one image up to 20 images as thumbnail images right from the results list, which means you can use the images to browse your results and decide which ones you want to explore further without having to open or download the records. And I'll demonstrate for you how that works. First, I'll show you how images work in a database that only has the cover drawings. We're in Derwent World Patents Index, and I've run a patent search for devices to help improve your golf swing. You'll find, by the way, that golf seems to produce a lot of patents. I've also limited the search to records that contain images using the command ImageAny Yes. That's I-M-G-A-N-Y parentheses yes. In most cases, you would search the records with and without images together, but this is for demonstration. Here's the results list, which does not show images, but if we click this title, we get the online view of the record, which includes the cover image. If we want to, we can save the image by right-clicking on it. And if you download the record in any format that includes the abstract, it will include the image. So here, if I select this record and go to Export Save as either a PDF or an RTF, and I set the drop-down to Citation Abstract, notice I do not need to check the box for Include Images. But I will get the drawing automatically as part of the abstract, because that's just how the records are created in this group of databases. For the next demo, I've gone into the 31 full-text patent databases, and I've run a similar search for golf swing devices. And here's the results list. We can view thumbnail images right from here, without having to click on anything or download anything. This means the images can be used to browse the list to help us quickly spot the patents that resemble what we're looking for. And this is a big time saver. Initially, you see up to 5 thumbnails if the patent has that many images. If I scroll down to this one, it says there are 24 images. And you can see up to 20 thumbnails without leaving the results list by clicking Show More. Now let's say these thumbnails resemble the kind of invention I'm looking for, or close enough that I want a better look. Now there are 2 ways I can do that. First, I can click on the title. This gives me what we call the web view of the patent, with tabs for seeing different parts of the record. And if I click the Images tab, I can see all of the images. Now if I want to look at both the text and the images at the same time, I can go to another tab. I'll make it Patent, and from there I can go to Bibliographic, for example, or Claims, and then click here on Show Images. So now we have a kind of split-screen view with the text on the left and the images on the right. On the right, I can scroll through all the images by clicking Next. If any of them are presented sideways in the record, I can click Rotate to turn them around. And if I want to see only the text for a while, I can toggle between the Show Images and Hide Images. And when I'm done looking at this record, I can click back to Results and return to the list. But there's a second way to get to that split-screen view, and you may like this way better. Instead of clicking on the title, you can go down to the thumbnail section and click Full Size. Now you have the split-screen view as a pop-up. The images are nice and big. Again, you can scroll through them or rotate them as needed. But also, using this window, you can go to the left side and click Next Result and move to the next record on your list. And for each record, you can scroll or rotate the images. And because it's a pop-up, when you're done with this full-size or split-screen view, you can just close it, and you're back where you left off on the results list. In this way, the images can give you a good look at the results that interest you very quickly and help you to skip past the ones that do not look like what you're seeking without having to read a lot of text. Let's do one more, one where we don't have so many records to work through. Let's say you'd like to patent a product for teachers or college professors. At the time I'm recording this, a lot of these teachers will want to wear a protective mask in class, or may even be required to wear one, and yet they need to be heard clearly by the class and maybe also over a program like Zoom, and perhaps also be recorded. So, what about the idea of a protective mask that has a microphone built in, and maybe either a built-in speaker or a cable that goes out to the audio equipment? Has that idea ever been patented yet? I've done a search in the full-text patent databases for masks and microphones, and I tried to focus on medical or protective masks so I wouldn't get too many masks for airplane pilots or deep sea divers. Surgeons, of course, also wear masks and need to be heard clearly by people around them. And here's a selection of results. Just by looking at the thumbnails, I can see that this one is more a mask for a respirator, not really what I want. And so is this one. And the next one is for underwater. But here, the title doesn't tell us much at all, but the thumbnails look a lot like what we want. So I'll click full size for a better look. And yes, this is one that I'll want to look at further. Back to the list. For the next two, the thumbnails are enough to show us that these are full face covers with goggles or something like a helmet, so we can skip them. Looking ahead, this one looks interesting. So again, we can use full size and we confirm that this is something we want to study further. Same thing for this one, and also this one. So you see how quickly we were able to sort through these results using the thumbnail images. So that's it. Based on the feedback that we get here at the help desk, I can tell you that the more searching someone does in the patent databases, the more they tell us that they rely on the patent images as an important tool for searching through their patent results. And I hope you will find this a useful technique also when using Dialog. If you'd like more information, here are some links to additional resources. And if you have any questions or you'd like some help, feel free to call the help desk at these numbers or email us at customer@dialog.com. Thanks for using Dialog, and enjoy the rest of your day.